Welcome to this week's edition of the Seneca Scout. I'm Caleb McGill.
And I'm Jack Stefanelli.
And we have a great show filled with local coverage from some of our arts and athletics on campus. It's our last show of October, and it's also the night of the final football game of the year. The Seneca Valley football team started the season off with a losing streak of 5 games. That was quickly turned around with them winning their first game against Butler's Golden Tornadoes, with Kai West having over 200 rushing yards in that game. That game was followed by 2 more wins against the Hempfield Spartans and the North Hills Indians. Now, after a loss against Central Catholic Vikings, the Seneca Valley Raiders play 1 more game home against the North Allegheny Tigers, which takes place the night of this broadcast. With the hopes of having a good offense, a good season has been stricken down with some upcoming players, Jaden Price, Tommy Weichen, Caden Parker, Zach Ross. They revitalized hope for the season, and we wish the Raiders luck in their last game, which has not yet happened at the time of this recording. With the football season coming to a close, let's check in with Maddie for a behind-the-scenes look at the Seneca Varsity Cheer is getting ready for the Pink Out Friday night game.
The Seneca Valley Raiders take on the North Allegheny Tigers for the last game of the season. This week, it is a very special week as we celebrate Breast Cancer Awareness.
Pink Out Week, are you guys doing anything special?
Yeah, we're wearing our Pink Out shirts and we're using pink pom-poms to support Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
So we have 95 cheerleaders and dancers, and this Friday night at the football game, we have all squads, 95 young ladies cheering and dancing, and we are with pink pom-poms and pink tattoos. We are encouraging all of our student section and our fans to also wear pink that evening.
As October 27th is the last Seneca game of the season, the cheerleaders on the sidelines have been living it up. This team consists of juniors and seniors, most of them who are cheering their whole life. We talked to senior Maddie Romito along with head coach Laura Wise about this season.
Since you're a senior, how are you taking in these last moments of your cheerleading?
I'm really just trying to make the best of it and always try and have fun because you're never going to get these moments back, so you really just have to embrace the time you have here.
Explain some obstacles that you had at the beginning of the season and how you were able to overcome them.
I think at the beginning of every season, the challenge is to be able to bring the teams together, because with a varsity team, you're taking juniors and seniors and blending them that weren't beforehand. You're taking brand new young ladies on 7th and 8th grade that never cheered before and are coming into the season. So the challenge really lies with making them be one family, one team, one unit. Towards the end, where we're all laughing and loud and having a great time as one team, as varsity, my challenge is bringing our dance team and our varsity cheer together as one unit blended of 41 young ladies. When we come together, we can cheer and dance, and we can really do all those squad dances together. And the cheerleaders taught the dancers some cheers, so that helps blend and not create that divide.
Make sure to tune in this Friday for a great game against the Tigers and to see what these cheerleaders have in store.
Thank you, Maddie, for the cheer update.
Seneca Valley's Culinary Arts 1 class are having their 3rd annual Halloween cake contest. Students design and plan their cakes accordingly, cake flavor, icing flavor, decorations, and if there will be any filling between the cake layers or not. The students learn baking skills such as separating whipping egg whites to a stiff peak, measuring ingredients, precisely because baking is a science, greasing a cake pan properly, and checking cake doneness. They learn how to prevent coming mistakes like dry and dense cakes or cakes that are deflate in the center. In different cake pans, students utilize their creativity to design a spooky and unique cake. Students must communicate well and work as a team and practice good time management skills. Culinary Arts 1 teacher, Ms. Ehrenberger, started this competition because she loves Halloween. It is a perfect opportunity for students to demonstrate their skills and share their results with the staff. Judging is open to all staff in the building.
A new club is coming to Seneca Valley for students to join. FBLA is Future Business Leaders of America Society, and a new club here where students can gain scholarships, new friends, and compete in competitions. FBLA introduces businesses and finance to students. The club will also include volunteer opportunities, challenges, working with a team, learning business, and a lot more. FBLA is sponsored by staff members, Ms. Brooks, Ms. Scholart, and Mrs. Squartz, and the student-involved leaders such as Samuel Boyer, Diane Gopala Krishnan, and the club has to be in the U.S. high schools since 1942, and Tennessee was the first to start it. FBLA prepares students for future business careers globally and being a leader. This club opens new doors for our school and our students.
Next up, we take a look at a story you might have missed that but has great consequences for the entire planet. Flowers are growing in Antarctica, and if scientists are scared, you should be too. More plants were found last month in Antarctica and are growing rapidly now. Two plants named Antarctica hairgrass and the Antarctic pearlwort were found 10 years ago, and scientists are trying to figure out why they have been blooming at exponential rates in the more recent years. The scientists studying this phenomenon want everyone to be more aware of this problem because they believe it has yet another reminder of the acceleration of climate change. But that's not the only problem with the climate change in Antarctica. In addition to the flowers blooming in Antarctica, there are still different species dying to at larger rates because in previous years because of climate change.
We led our show with athletics, and now we take a look at one of the committees helping with leadership and increasing attendance in SV athletic events.
SALT, or Student Athlete Leadership Team, has been a committee for 2 years now, run by Athletic Director Heather Lewis and Assistant Athletic Director Soa Doku. Students have had the opportunity to take charge of athletics around the school, from increasing attendance for games to helping with events in the community. Students in SALT can help make a difference. Once a month, students meet and discuss various things that affect Seneca Valley athletics.
My name is Niso Doku, or Mr. Soa Doku.
How long have you been working at Seneca Valley?
About a year and a half now.
What is the main highlight for SALT?
The main highlight for SALT is bringing the student athletes together to collaborate and advocate for themselves. SALT helps the student athletes advocate for themselves and creates a space where they can talk freely and kind of create ideas for themselves as well as the future of Seneca Valley Athletics. My job for SALT is just being one of the liaisons that student athletes can work with, bounce ideas off of, and help them improve Seneca Valley Athletics.
Do you think SALT is going to help Seneca Valley Athletics in the long run?
Yes, very much so. When Ms. Lewis created this program, it was more so that we didn't know what the student athlete experience was like, so we don't know what we don't know. So now that we do have this SALT group, we're able to learn about what the student athlete experience is, what we can do to improve their experiences and kind of improve things for the future.
My name is Eddie Kurtz, or Mr. Kurtz. I'm one of the assistant athletic directors here at Seneca Valley. I started working at Seneca Valley in July, so I'm still somewhat new. To me, SALT's very important. It was one of the big things that I was excited about when coming on to Seneca Valley. I love to see the student athletes and the students just get interactive with the community and involved with each other to just really help better the overall experience for the student athlete and for the student in general. So SALT, it teaches them how to lead, how to work together, teaches them how to kind of game plan, and honestly just work together in subgroups of how we can make the community better, how they can become better leaders, and work within subgroups and work amongst each other in ways to help improve their community, their athletic experience, and their just overall school experience.
Thank you, Jack, for the in-depth look at the new SALT committee.
This past Wednesday, the Seneca Valley Orchestra had their second annual Halloween concert at the Strand Theater. This concert not only plays Halloween hits, but also serves as a costume contest for the orchestra members. The winner of the contest receives a custom-made badge that says Best Costume. Famous songs like This Is Halloween and Fright Night, which is a combination of songs from movies such as Jaws and Phantom of the Opera, will be played as well. The orchestra did an amazing job with every song. Make sure to check them out for the February Valentine's Day concert for the second Strand performance of the school year.
We end tonight with a closer look into recent changes to SVTV. Seneca Valley's Television Broadcast Club recently got a revitalization with a new press box as well as new cameras and fiber optic infrastructure. As the club is student-led, many see this as an opportunity as an investment for students. We interviewed club sponsors and SVTV students to get their thoughts on these updates.
Seneca Valley recently adopted a new press box for their football stadium to modernize the state of the school. One such upside in this is granting a space for SVTV, Seneca Valley's Television Broadcast Club, where they can broadcast all events held at the stadium. In addition to this, SVTV recently began using new, better quality cameras for broadcasting. This means for SVTV, among other things, they will be able to broadcast events in better quality. With the club broadcasting all home football games, senior nights for both boys and girls, as well as concerts, the ease of use has been valuable for SBTV and their endeavors. I interviewed club sponsors Mr. McCoskey and Mrs. Plutnicki to give better insight as to how the step-up in equipment impacts how they run the club.
The press box is an incredible upgrade, not just for SBTV, but I think for anyone athletics related. We struggled in that old press box. Part of it was our own inability to keep it clean and our wires, you know, in good condition, but we could barely fit our students in that little area. The windows were so small that we couldn't really pan left and right without seeing part of it. So it wasn't ideal for us, but this is a huge upgrade.
I think a new press box here at Seneca Valley has been a great benefit, even beyond the scope of SVTV. You know, a press box actually can be the center of the community in terms of these sporting events, because it allows other people to, you know, enjoy that sporting event from a different vantage point, but also it allows us to socialize with those other coaches, with those other schools, to set up a little bit more of a sportsmanship or a camaraderie in that regard. And I think that those are very beneficial things.
I do believe that the new hardware and the new infrastructure for SBTV is an investment for the students. When you look at the signal that's being processed and you realize that that's a signal that looks like it's 20 or 30 years old, you could see how students would lose interest and they want to do something that looks a little bit more current.
I do consider the new hardware for Seneca Valley Television to be an investment for the students. I believe this because, you know, this is the new industry, you know, standard.
Another indirect upside of the new equipment is the upswing in new members for the club. Prospective students interested in video journalism and broadcast can now join a club that provides them with modern, state-of-the-art equipment. Several students gave their thoughts on the state of the club.
This year we were given a lot of new equipment in the press box, namely fiber, which brings us into the 21st century by sending little pulses of light over cables of glass back to the studio, and allows us to do it in HD, which is really cool.
My favorite part about the new equipment is the ease of access that it gives us. It is just a lot easier to use and simpler to have.
For the viewers at home, there's more clear quality.
Ms. Lewis, athletic director for Seneca Valley, was instrumental in creating and designing the new press box for the district. Among other responsibilities, she had to coordinate, plan, and schedule the execution of the design of the press box, and how it will address the needs of all athletic clubs that can take advantage of its benefits. This is what she had to say.
So when we thought about building this new press box, one of the reasons that we did is to provide space for the needs of a 6A athletics program. And one of the groups that I think really has benefited from it is our SVTV group, who now has their own dedicated broadcasting room. And so they are not trying to broadcast a live football game and still have, you know, coaches on the other side of the wall where that can be heard, or having a radio broadcast right next to them. So the advantage of this new press box is there are individual rooms with doors and walls and so forth so that we can do multiple broadcasts. We did this project in the 22-23 school year between the end of football season and the start of track season. And so we had a really short window of about 3 months, 3.5 months to get this done. And so a lot of work had been done ahead of time, off site, and literally the day our final event happened in the fall sports, they came in, knocked down the old press box, and started digging the trenches and putting the footers and support beams and everything in place. And so we didn't finish exactly on time, but I will say this, it was just a wonderful collaboration to get it done in time that our track teams and lacrosse teams were able to benefit from using this press box last year. Quite honestly, it's one of the smoother projects in terms of scheduling and collaboration with the people who designed it and installed it that I've been involved in my 12 years here.
That's all, folks. We hope to see you next week for our next edition of the Seneca Scouts.